Have you seen people put metal blocks like this into their glider's wings and ask yourself, what the heck are they doing? And have these people also been messing around with these fancy 3D printed CG scales? And have you asked yourself, should I also put additional weight into my glider? If you want answers to these questions, stay tuned. In today's video, I want to show you the purpose of ballasting your RC plane. I will show you how I ballast my glider for F3B contests, but I can already tell you that this knowledge is not only for contest pilots, but also for hobby pilots that want to get the most out of their glider. If you have any F3B related question or questions on ballasting planes, please leave a comment below. And if you learned something today, I would appreciate if you hit the like button. This shows me and also the algorithm of YouTube that this content is important for you. There are mainly two options to put the ballast in. One is the fuse and the other is the wings. The fuse is not the best option nowadays because the fuses of the F3B and F3F planes got pretty narrow, so there's not a lot of space to put ballast in. The better option is to put it into the wings. Most planes have special ballast pockets where ballast pieces like these fit in, and another option is to put it into the joiner, but that depends on the plane you fly, if there's space in the joiner or not. Most manufacturers will provide you with a special package of ballast for your plane. That's a good and easy solution. But if you want to save some money or you don't know who built your plane, then it's another good option to get to a local hardware shop or maybe on the internet to get the ballast. I got mine from a hardware shop online, just measured the ballast pockets in my glider and got the fitting pieces from the online shop. Another advantage of this is that you can get the ballast exactly as you like it. My ballast pieces are 125 grams and 50 grams. The best solution is brass. Brass is easy to machine, has a higher density than steel, is non-toxic. Another option would be lead, which is not so healthy. Another option is tungsten, which is even heavier than the lead, but not that easy to get, pretty expensive and hard to machine. To use the full advantage of ballasting your plane, you should always be aware of the position of your CG when ballasting your plane. So you have to know the weight of the plane, and you also have to know where the CG is moving when you put the ballast in the different places. That is why I always have a table of my CG and total weight of the model in my ballast box. So depending on the conditions, I can decide if I want to put my CG a bit more to the back and put some more weight on my plane, or if I want to go a bit lighter and move the CG a bit more to the front. If you move the CG of your glider, the flight characteristics will change. I'm not talking about changing it like 5 millimeters or something. You have to find a pretty good spot by flying your model empty. But starting from there, it might help your flying if you put it a bit to the back or a bit to the front. Putting it a bit to the front will make your glider fly a bit more stable and also make the circling and the thermals much easier. But moving it to the back will make your glider much more agile and more responsive to control inputs. And that is exactly what you're looking for if you want to fly an F3B task like speed or distance, where you have to make sudden changes in direction with as less control input as possible. So if you want to play around with the CG of your plane, I would heartily recommend you to get one of these 3D printed CG scales. You can make it yourself. I will put a link in the description so you can find the open source project on GitHub. You can also buy these things or maybe borrow them from your friends. I will make a separate video on my YouTube channel where I will show you how to use these CG scales decently and how you can easily vary the ballasting on your plane without having to disassemble it every time, because that would be a lot of work. But this will be in another video, so if you are interested, please hit the subscribe button to my channel so you will not miss the video when it comes out. Well, that is a very important question, and I will not bore you with any aerodynamic theory. Long story short, the faster you want to fly, the heavier your plane should be. And the further you want to fly, the heavier your plane should be. Period. But there's one more thing. You have to get it in the air. So the heavier your plane is, the harder it gets to get it up on the winch line. So the weight of your model is a central tactic decision when it comes to contest flying. And that is what makes it so exciting to be on a contest. Everyone has to adapt to the conditions and make his own decision how he wants to ballast his plane.